Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Haley and Honey. If it's your first time here, then welcome. So I want to share with you guys some benefits to celibacy, things that people don't really talk about or tell you about, but I'm gonna keep it real with you. I love sharing with you about self-love and our feminine energy, getting to know ourselves and heal ourselves like from the inside out. And so you don't have to be spiritual to be on a celibacy journey, but you're gonna become spiritual, okay? You're gonna start seeing synchronicities, you're gonna have like vivid dreams, you're gonna become so sensitive energetically because we're all spirits in a body. And so celibacy is this beautiful chance to take a break and focus in on your own self, and your own spirit might reveal things to you. So three benefits to celibacy. Okay, what's the first one? I think that something really powerful that happens on your celibacy journey is that you learn how to release your past. Okay, like I feel like this is one of the best benefits of celibacy, because sometimes when you're in a relationship, you're not able to see so clearly. Like there's a lot of emotions involved, and especially if you've gone through a breakup, it can be hard to release your ex. Like, it can be hard to fully let go, really move on. A lot of times what we don't realize is that sex was playing a huge, it was like putting blinders on you a lot of times. And so for me on my celibacy journey, I was able to look back into my past relationships and see myself more clearly and the relationship more clearly, to know like, was I really in love? Or if not, why was I with this person? And so celibacy gives you like a clear view, and it helps you cut soul ties, release clear energy. It's very healing to your own heart and body and mind. And so you're able to let go of your past much easier. Before I was celibate, let's say I went through a breakup, it wouldn't be so long before I started talking to somebody new or hanging out with somebody new. My attention, like, you just kind of go from like relationship to relationship, you can. And so when you're celibate, it's a break. It's like a chunk in time that you're able to examine yourself and really heal, like really let people go. And also look at the patterns, like the type of people you were dating, why didn't it work out, so that you have a better chance to like break those bad patterns and choose somebody who's healthier for you. You're able to like see why you were making certain decisions. So for me, during this break, I've learned when it comes to relationships, what I want versus what I don't want, what has worked for me versus what hasn't worked. And looking at my own self, I've learned, like, the universe has forced me to learn about patience, and I'm still learning about patience. When you rush in life, whether it's in a relationship, whether it's having sex, anything, like, if you're moving too fast, there could be some really crazy, harsh consequences. And a lot of times you don't get what it is that you actually want. So patience is a virtue, and it's like a spiritual superpower to learn how to be patient, be humble, and trust God, trust the universe. Looking at my past relationships, I got entangled in things from just moving too fast, and even became a mother. And so that's why this has been a beautiful time to check my own self and learn about me. Why was I doing those things? And a lot of times we just do things like without thinking. And so that's why I see celibacy as like a chance to heal, but also a chance to mature and come from a healthier place. You deserve this. And also you're being led, like your spirit is leading you. You're not missing out on anything. Sex is not going anywhere. You can still tap into your pleasure physically with your own self, or doing things that make you feel like you're on a high, like art or exercise or dance or something creative, something exhilarating outside with nature. Even taste, like you become so sensitive to life, simple pleasures. Because if you get too consumed with sex, then you might think that that's the only way you can feel really excited or like blissful on a high, like orgasm. You might feel like nothing can compare to that, but I'm telling you that after 3.5 years celibate, there are other things that bring me excitement now, and they last longer. It's more deeply fulfilling and satisfying. One of those things is like real love for myself, real love for another. Because if you're moving too fast when it comes to a relationship, you don't give yourself a chance to fall in love. You're not in love. You can't. We might think we are, but real love takes time. It takes so much time. All that happens is you start building a root deeper, 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 and getting down to the layers of you and another. And so that will happen for you, but you have to be patient. And so I've learned so much about my choices in relationships and what I now desire, what's truly would make me feel happy. And it's helped me to like have a clean slate, release the exes and forgive myself, forgive them. So moving on doesn't just mean never talking to somebody again. Oh, being in your pride, like, oh, so cool, because like I blocked them, so whatever. Like, no. The real flex is inner peace. Like, the real flex is, nah, you're really over it. Not because you hate them, but because you forgive them and you forgive you. You see yourself and them with clearer eyes, and you have compassion for the situation. You have appreciation for that other soul. You know that you guys are soulmates in some capacity. That's why you cross paths. That's why you spoke I love you type of words, or had sex, or whatever the situation was, right? And instead of having bitterness, you have appreciation and a bit of sweetness, tenderness. It doesn't mean you want to be back with them. It means you see them through loving eyes, because it's one love. They're just another version of you. That's really healing, and that's really moving on, is being able to look at your past with compassion and be gentle with it, but also keep it real with yourself and check yourself. Okay, well, why was I doing that? Why was I allowing that? Why did things end? Did I stay too long? There's really no such thing as that, because you're always constantly learning, whether it's in the moment or later on. But I would say like one of the biggest benefits to celibacy is being able to see your past with clearer eyes, practice forgiveness, which can take some time and patience, and being able to truly move on, release it, let it go, so that you can make space in your mind, a space in your heart for something new, for someone new, someone who is going to match your vibration at this present moment. You know, because as you heal, you're going to change. You're going to be a whole new you. When you've been celibate, there's a lot of times you're not able to reconnect with your exes that you had years prior, because you no longer resonate. Like, you're on a whole different wave. Your mind has changed. It's healed. You've healed. You've grown as a person. So you're not gonna vibe. Like, it's not the same version of you. So there's like a misalignment there. Like, you're going like this. Like, you're gonna miss each other because you're not on the same stuff anymore. And maybe they are, or maybe they're not. It's like, so you grow apart. But there's so many, life can be so complex, so sometimes it's tough to move on. But if you have gone through a breakup recently, then I definitely encourage celibacy. Like, the world is going to tell you, oh, to move on, just go hook up with somebody else real quick, or get real drunk or high or whatever, go on a shopping spree, all these toxic things, not, or like eat a bunch of food, sit there with a tub of ice cream, like, nah, don't do none of that. Like, to actually move on and feel better, practice celibacy, like, because it's gonna help, it's like gonna speed up the healing process, but you still have to be patient. Okay, so what's the second beautiful benefit to celibacy? I'd say self-love, because you're on your own, right? You're in your big old bed by yourself, and you get to love up on yourself, and It's crazy the things that were revealed to me, like when I started this journey, even about like my childhood, things that I would have never known. But when you start to look at your past relationships and some of your patterns or whatever, it's all a learning process. So you're gonna be like, well, why was I doing that? And for me, I learned some not so great things about just my own upbringing and my own self. Self-love looks like being able to face all parts of you, the good, the bad, the ugly, and just being soft with yourself, being there for yourself, and loving up on yourself, and seeing how you can make a change for the better, which change can be hard sometimes. But if that means breaking bad habits or taking on new habits, being around healthier people. When I started my celibacy journey, I changed up the crowd that I was around. Like I was to myself, but when I would like tune into stuff online, I made sure, like I unfollowed so many people on Instagram, on YouTube, or whatever I was on, Facebook at the time probably. Like if it's not serving you, then you gotta let it go. Because celibacy is about like you're on more of a clear path and more of a righteous path. And so you're gonna be able to tell real quick, like if somebody's on some BS or if it's negative energy, if it's toxic, polluting your mind, or if it's helping you evolve, if it's feeding you with love, if it's feeding you life, if you're learning new things, if they're your real friends, if they're really there for you and want you to do well, want you to succeed, and you're there for each other. And so it's a very beautiful journey. Self-love and making healthier connections with like a new crowd a lot of times. Also, of course, connecting with the divine, your spirit guides, angels, like we're so protected on our life journey, but it's easy to miss. But celibacy is this beautiful chance to connect with your inner self, and life is a reflection of your inner world. So the more beautiful you make your inner world, the more beautiful you're gonna see the outside world. Now, when I walk out of the house, I'm like, I'm a fairy out here. Like, I'm seeing the most beautiful creations. It's the same world, but it's a new set of eyes. Okay, guys, so three benefits to celibacy that you might not hear about. Okay, so what's number three? Because we talked about releasing your past, learning how to fully move on, cut soul ties, let go, make space for something new in your life. And we talked about self-love, like learning how to develop healthier relationship with yourself and attracting like healthier relationships into your life. I'd say like the third benefit to celibacy that people might not tell you but is so real is that you have a chance to attract true love. Yes, I said it. I didn't write this one down. It's just coming from my heart, but it's very beautiful because when you go on a true healing process, right? You're not playing around. You're making sacrifices and you're devoted to your own growth, self-healing, and just learning about yourself, taking your time to do this because not everyone will do it or has the desire or the discipline to do it. And so you are going to be gifted. You have a chance to learn about your own energy, your own power, and co-create with the universe. So set your intentions. The longer you're on your celibacy journey, you're going to know yourself better and you're going to discover what you want, and you can declare what you want. Journal it out, write it out, set wishes, prayers. Prayers we've been taught is about begging to God, God, please make this happen. But you don't have to. You can simply recognize that God is within you as well and make a declaration and don't be afraid. Like, no wish is too big when it comes to attracting a healthy relationship because sex is beautiful and love is powerful. Like, we deserve these things, but it's about a healthy love, a true love, healthy relationships, and releasing all of the past, right? And so you're able to attract true love and decide what this would look like for you and leave space for magic, leave space for the universe to work. The universe is always listening to you. I promise you guys, I've told you this before, but I'm gonna share it with anyone who's new here. When I was like 7 years old, in my head as a little girl, I dreamed of what my dream guy would be like. I thought of a specific accent that I wanted him to have. I thought about the color skin tone I wanted him to have and how he would be. And I wanted him to have a perfect smile. Like, I came up with all these things as a little girl. And then I would start, like, not acting like him, but I only, like, told my brother about it. And I would start talking in that accent to him. And he would get so annoyed. And so I thought this is just, like, something innocent that I did as a kid. Okay, well, like, I forgot about it. So set your intention to the universe. Say, like, you have to open your heart to love and be vulnerable and be like, I want to attract true love. And it will happen for you, you guys. When I started my celibacy journey, I kid you not, the universe, like, it's like that guy that I dreamed of when I was a little girl appeared in my reality. Okay, that's all I have to say about that. But the universe is listening. Okay, so set your intentions. Open your heart to love and don't be in a rush. Take your time because what's meant for you will come. But it's about what you feel deserving of. So do you know that you're worthy of real love, of beautiful love? Not that it's going to be perfect, but that it's going to be perfect for you. What your heart desires, what it needs. And so celibacy is like you doing your part. And then true love is like a blessing that will pour into your life from the universe. So these are my three benefits of celibacy. Kind of romantic there at the end. I'm sending you so much love and power and healing on your journey. Take care of yourself. Oh, it's hot. I'm like sweating. It's 110 in Phoenix, you guys. Where are you in the world? I'm sending you so much love and power. Take care of yourself. And I'll see you next time. Bye.